Now we come to the case where R is external to the vector joining P and Q. It goes, becomes external, right? And I have to find the value of R. Now there are again two ways of doing the same thing. Okay. How do we go about it? Either you take the vector PR. So PR is what? PR is? Vector PR is? R minus A. What is vector QR? It is? R minus B. Okay. R minus A, R minus B. Now what? So QR we have PR. Now what do? I again do the same thing. What is PR cap? The length of PR is M. So it is R minus A upon MK. Length is MK actually. Okay. And what is the length of QR, that is NK, so it is and are they equal? Yes. Why? Because they have the same length. They are pointing in the same direction. So I get R minus A upon MK is equal to R minus B upon NK. K cancels and we get N into R minus A, M into R minus B. So that gives me MB minus NA. Is equal to MR minus NR. So R is equal to okay. Needless to say that it again contains all the three informations of about X, Y, Z. Okay. We could have also utilized that Q divides PR internally in the ratio N into N is to M minus N. That would have given you the same result. Okay. So if that was that, then I would have used the value for the formula for internal, because Q is internally dividing PR in the ratio N is to M minus N. So it would have given us M minus N into R. No? M minus N into R. It crosses, right? Plus NA upon M minus N plus N is equal to B. So it becomes M minus N R plus NA is equal to MB. So M minus R would have become MB minus NA. So R would have become MB minus NA upon M minus N. The same result. Okay, it would have given you the same result.